Good morning students. In the last lecture we discussed about some properties of this superposition of two simple harmonic motion, and we see the condition for the constructive and the destructive interference. Today we are going to discuss another very important topic, that is nothing but the velocity of sound in air. So the velocity of sound in air is determined or calculated by two scientists, Newton and Laplace. Newton assumed that the process is isothermal, but the value of the speed of or the velocity of sound is different from the actual value. So then Laplace corrected the formula, and then we get the approximate value of this velocity of sound in air. So we are going to discuss Newton's formula as well as the Laplace's correction. So what is Newton's formula? Let us start. Newton stated that when the two simple harmonic motions are interfere with each other, there is a formation of alternate compression and rarefaction. There is a formation of compression and rarefaction, and there is an alternate formation of compression and rarefaction. But this production of compression and rarefaction is nothing but a isothermal process. So we are seeing the Newton's formula, which state that the production of compression and rarefaction is a isothermal process. What is isothermal? Isothermal process in which the temperature of the system remains constant. So Newton assumed that the production of compression and rarefaction is a very slow process, and due to this slow process the temperature of the medium remains constant. Means one thing again we must remember about this Newton's formula. He states that the process of the formation of compression and rarefaction is a slow process, and due to which the heat or the temperature of the medium, gaseous medium, does not increase, it remains constant. So this is Newton's assumption. Now we are moving towards the ideal gas equation for the isothermal process, and this equation can be written as this: PV is equal to constant. We know PV is equal to RT, but as the temperature is constant and R is a gas constant, so we can write here PV is equal to constant. Now if we differentiate this equation, so we get it is P into dV by V plus it is V into dV by dV, which is equal to 0, because the derivative of constant is equal to 0. Now this is P plus V into dP by dV, which is equal to 0. Now therefore we can write here this P is equal to minus dP by dV into V, or we can also write this as minus dP upon dV by V. This is the P. But we know that this value dP upon dV by V is nothing but a ratio of volume stress to volume strain, which is known as a bulk modulus. So we can write here this bulk modulus E, elasticity, it is equal to, it is minus dP upon dV by V. It is volume stress divided by volume strain. So we can write this E is equal to P. We know that the velocity of sound in air or the velocity of longitudinal wave is given by, it is given by, it is V is equal to under root E divided by rho. What is rho? Rho is the density of the medium through which this sound is passing. Okay, so this is equal to, now what is this E? This E is nothing but the bulk modulus of the air, and which is equal to pressure P. So we can write here is equal to P divided by rho. Now what is the P? The P can be calculated as, it is equal to H rho G divided by rho. Now this can be calculated as this H for the normal temperature patient is equal to 0.76 into density. Density of the mercury, the density of the mercury is equal to 13,600, and into gravity is equal to 9.8. And this rho is the density of the air, that is equal to 1.293. If we calculate this value, this values come out to be 280 meter per second. So the actual value, the actual value of the velocity of sound in air is approximately equal to 332 meter per second. So while Newton assumed this is an isothermal process and a slow process, we get a value equal to 280 meter per second, but which is vary in the actual value, that is 332 meter per second, by a large amount. So there must be some drawbacks in the assumption by Newton. So Laplace says find out the drawbacks and corrected the formula. Now what he assumed, Newton assumed it is an isothermal and slow process, but what Laplace is assumed, we are going to see now. So we are moving towards the Laplace's correction in the velocity of sound in air. So Laplace's correction. So what the assumption, what are the assumptions of Laplace's correction or by the Laplace's? Laplace's assume that the production of compression and rarefaction, it is a fast process. It is a fast process. And as it is a fast process, there must be the increase in the temperature of the system. Therefore, it is not an isothermal process, but it is an adiabatic process. So according to Laplace, the production of compression and rarefaction is nothing but a fast process, and it is a adiabatic process. Adiabatic process means the heat content remains constant. Heat content remains constant, but the temperature can increase. So therefore, the assumptions made by Laplace are opposite, exactly opposite to that of Newton. Now we know the ideal gas equation PV is equal to constant for a isothermal process, but this equation is changes to PV to the power gamma is equal to constant. What is gamma? Gamma is nothing but the adiabatic ratio, that is Cp divided by Cv. So this PV to the power gamma is equal to constant. Now we are going to differentiate this equation, and how we can differentiate. So the differentiation is equal to, let's see, it is b to the power gamma into dp by dv plus p into gamma into v to the power of gamma minus 1, which is equal to 0. In this way, we can differentiate this equation. Now, divide this equation by p to the power p into v to the power gamma minus 1. So, we can write here it is v to the power gamma divided by this. Gamma minus 1 into dp by dv plus this p into gamma into v to the power gamma minus 1 and divided by v to the power gamma minus 1, which is equal to 0. So this gets cancelled. So we get here v to the power gamma upon v to the power gamma minus 1 into dp by dv plus p multiplied by gamma is equal to 0. Now, what is this? We can write it as v to the power gamma minus gamma plus 1. Okay, into dp by dv plus p multiplied by gamma is equal to 0. This plus gamma minus gamma we cancel. So we can write here v to the power 1. So it is v into dp by dv plus p multiplied by gamma is equal to 0. So now this p multiplied by gamma is equal to minus v into dp by dv, which is equal to minus dp upon dv by dv. So it is p multiplied by gamma. But what is this? This is nothing but the bulk modulus of the air, which is denoted by delta p. So we know the velocity of longitudinal wave, that is sound, is equal to v is equal to under root e divided by rho. Now we can replace this e with p multiplied by gamma, or we can write this gamma multiplied by p divided by rho. So for air, the value of gamma is equal to 1.41. And the value of p, we can also write this as 1.41 into 0.76 into 13,600 into 9.8, and is divided by the density of the air, which is 1.29. Okay. If we solve this equation, we get the value 331.4 meter per second. This value is in a very good agreement with the actual value found, that is equal to 332 meter per second. So the assumption made by Newton in the sense of velocity of sound in air is wrong, while Laplace is corrected this assumption by state that the production of compression and rarefaction is a fast process and is a adiabatic process. So in this way, today we discuss about the velocity of sound in air, Newton's formula, and then the correction by the Laplace. So this is enough for today. Have a good day. Bye.